Hello folks, welcome to my YouTube. My name is Alex and in this video I just want to give a brief explanation of what you might be looking at when you first open Bitwig. I'd like to level the playing field between those who may be migrating over from Ableton and already know most of what's going on in here, and those of you who have never opened anything close to this kind of a program. Okay, so I'm going to keep it short and sweet and let's get started. Okay, so when you first open Bitwig, you're greeted with this screen here. This is the dashboard, and I kind of like this feature. Adobe's been putting it in their software for years now, and I like it because I get to choose right off the bat. It doesn't automatically choose a new project or to open my last project. I get to choose. You won't have anything here if it's your first time. But just go ahead and click new project. I already have one loaded up. So, okay. So first things first, actually one thing I want to show you is if you right click up here, you can increase, I think when I got Bitwig, it was like this big. Okay. So right off the bat, change this depending on your preference. I like mine a little bit smaller because I like to see like a bigger overview of my track. Okay. I just want to get that out of the way. I think I'll leave it at this size just for the purpose of the YouTube video so that you can still see. Okay, so I'm a firm believer that the more you learn and know about something, the less it's able to intimidate you or scare you. And that's kind of what I'm hoping to do with this video here. I want to just show you what you're looking at here so that when you open it, you don't go, oh, holy crap, and then close it again. Because I think the reason why people get these programs to begin with is because they want to create the music that they hear in their head. And being intimidated by it is just simply not a good enough excuse to keep you from actually doing that. I know I want to hear your track, and for sure you want to hear your own track, and maybe the rest of the world does. And so let's not get discouraged, okay? I'm confident that within a reasonable amount of time, you'll be decently comfortable in here and you'll be well on your way to making music. And certainly if you do create a song and you want to share it, leave it in the comment section, leave a link to it down below, or email me directly. I'd love to hear what you guys come up with. Okay, all right, so the first thing that we're looking at here is your timeline, or I guess technically it's called the arranger view. Okay, here you have your ruler, which is just your beats and bars and the lines that tell you the beginning of a bar or a beat. And obviously time goes from left to right. And here you have all your tracks. This could be drums and guitars and pads, synths, whatever you got, okay? One way that I look at this is that it's just a digital tape machine, really. When they were inventing audio programs, remember, they were really just trying to replace the tape machine. And back then, if you wanted to cut a clip or one bar out of a song, you had to find that bar in the song and actually cut the tape on some kind of an angle and then cut it at the end of the bar and then tape them together. We're already here. We can just do this and we're done, okay? So already that's a massive advantage over tape machines. Don't worry about what I just did right there. We're going to get into that a little bit later. The important thing to know is that right here, you're basically looking at little pieces of tape, except that they're digital, and you're going to write music from left to right. Okay? The next thing I'll direct your attention to is this browser here. Okay? You can hide it and open it and close it by pressing Option B. For browser, press it twice, and there you go. You can open it and close it. And this is basically the looking glass into your computer. Any audio that you have in here, whether it's samples, it could even be MIDI data, and even your plugins, it's all going to exist in here, and you can organize it in such a way that your workflow is super fluid, okay? And we're gonna do that in the next video, because this thing is sweet. This thing is dope, okay? And you're gonna use it a lot. So we'll go ahead and set that up. over here you have this here, and it's called your info screen. And again, I for info, you press option I, press it twice, you can close it, press it again, you can open it. And it's considered a dynamic panel. So depending on what you click on, it's going to change its properties to suit what you're currently working off. I'm working on this clip. I can quickly look over here and I can change its color. I can give it a name. I can loop it, choose my fade ins, everything like that. If I'm on a track, it'll show me any instruments I have on there, the track volume, whether I'm in record or not, anything like that. Okay. So again, this might look intimidating, but don't worry about it. We're going to get into it. Just for now, realize that this is changing to accommodate wherever you click. Okay. All right. Up here, you'll notice that there's no file, edit, view, window, help, nothing like that. And that's actually a good thing, because those don't never change. If you want like the help, for example, you click the dashboard button, which is just that Bitwig, and there's help. But for as far as file goes, it's in here. And the reason why it's better is because I can pin the things I'm going to use most often right there in full view. I actually pinned open there, and I'm never going to use it, so I'm going to unpin it, and you see how it disappears. And if I want it there, I can leave it. I'm actually going to leave that off. And that's true for this entire thing. If I click on a clip, see how that came up? That wasn't there before. That's there because I clicked on clip and I pinned those things, because I use these often. I often bounce in place, and I often reverse and consolidate my clips. Okay. So as we go through the tutorials, you're going to customize this to your own liking, and so that you don't have to click through menus to get to the stuff you know you're going to use anyway. Of course, I always recommend using the quick keys. And if you're curious about if you want to know what the quick key is for something, just press, I believe it is option enter. No, sorry, control enter, and it brings up all your quick keys. Okay. All right. So down here, this is basically your edit window. You're going to edit audio, edit MIDI, and you can even edit the devices on a channel. If I click double click there, obviously I don't have any devices, but I could easily click plus and I can throw something down there, and it could be an effect, like a reverb, anything. And you're basically, yeah, just remember this as your edit, your devices panel. And again, you can hide that by pressing D, and bring it up by pressing D. And that will change depending on what you double click. If I double click this, it's bringing this up for me. If I want to full screen that, you press Shift Tab. And now you're editing in full screen here, and your devices are down below. And that's super handy. That's one of the improvements they made over Ableton, is that you can full screen edit without having to click here and drag. Okay. So Shift Tab again, and it returns us here. Okay. Up here is your tempo, and you can change that by clicking and scrolling. And this is your time signature. We're in 4/4. This is telling you how much CPU you're using. If this thing is cranked, which is decently hard to do in Bitwig because of their sandboxing feature, if this thing is cranked, you're going to hear clicks and pops. But don't worry about that. We'll get into it later. Here's how you loop a section, right? This is your looper, and you can loop that. So it'll just keep playing this over and over and over. You can turn the click track or metronome on and off. And if you want to set the tempo of this click track, it's right there. And if you want to tap tempo, hold Control Option and tap on the space bar, and that will change it. Here, for example, see how it's changing? I'm just holding Control Option and tapping the space bar. Okay, you can double click it to edit it. Okay, so if you're familiar with Ableton, you can press Tab, and now you're over here in the session view. And if you're not familiar with these programs, I just sucked your brain into a wormhole, because this is different. And this is good for live sessions. So you can have however many tracks you have. Each one of these boxes represent a loop of audio, okay? and you can press play scene and it will play all the boxes, for example, on the top row. So if you're playing live, you can sit this beside your drummer and he can trigger these scenes and it will go to the next track of whatever audio you have in here. I'm not going to go too much into this right now or very early in my tutorial because this is mostly for live. And I mean, people do use it to record their music, but for me, my workflow is like this, left to right, the classic kind of audio program way of doing it, because you can see everything and how it's laid out. And I just prefer, that's a personal preference of mine. Definitely experiment with that. And so you just press tab to get to it and tab to get out of it. If you want to see it in this screen, you can actually press L. L for looper, or actually, I think it's launcher. And that brings up this. So here you go again. There's your tracks all laid out here, all your loops, and then you can press the scene to play all these loops simultaneously. Okay. So, that's I think about it. Here, I made this for you. I hope this gets you to, to subscribe more than me just saying, "Oh, please subscribe." And do you see how that's an advantage with using the browser? Is I made this earlier. Before I made this video, I created this. And now I drag it in, and already it's got the MIDI data, it's got the organ put on it, everything like that. And do you actually want to hear what this sounds like? It is gonna sound awesome. Oh yeah. That's a hit. Wow, that was painful. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna make a video right now of turning this into something that doesn't make you want to put a screwdriver in your eardrums, just for interest's sake. So, okay, so the next video I'm gonna do that, and then the video after that, we're gonna set this sucker up. Okay, my cat Michael Jackson's looking at me like, yeah, that's brilliant. I know. Okay. All right, guys. So again, the important thing to take away from this entire video is just that I just don't want you to get discouraged, okay? So much of making music in the first place is persevering through this, the feelings of crippling self-doubt that you will no doubt incur. And I want to hear your music, and I know you do too. So definitely stick with it. If you work hard at it, within a week for sure, you can be creating some pretty dope tracks. Okay. And again, if you do that, leave them down below. Leave a link to them down below. Let's have a listen. And if you have any comments or questions, definitely email me. I am a person, a real human. I have email, and I will set aside some time every day to try to reply to you guys. Okay. Alrighty. So lastly, please subscribe and like or comment. Alrighty. See you later.